talking about the average output voltage calculation for the three-phase full-wave rectifier. The rectifier is shown down here. We have our three-phase voltages, and they're all equally spaced by 120 degrees. And we have six diodes here that produce full rectification, full wave rectification. This is the output voltage here. This is our little bumpy output voltage here. And each of, within one period, there's six different bumps that you can see at the top. This is actually the line-to-line voltage. The peak value here is the line-to-line voltage. And that means you have to multiply the peak value by a square root of 3, which is here. So we want to find the average voltage here. And because it's repeating, we can again divide it, pick our own zero, and then just integrate over the portion that is repeating. So if we set this line as zero, we only have to integrate from here to here, which is actually 1/12 of the period. So 2 pi divided by 12 is pi over 6. So we can just integrate over this tiny interval. So here's our average voltage, and we're going to do it in radians because it's easier. And we do 1 over the total period, so pi over 6. And then we integrate from 0 to pi over 6. And we do the function here. Because this is line-to-line voltage, we're going to have to multiply by another square root of 3 here, then the RMS voltage, and then the square root of 2. So this is our setup, and then we have our cosine. Next, we can move our constants outside of the integral and flip our ratio around here and combine some different terms, and we'll get this expression, constants at the front. And then we're just integrating from 0 to pi over 6 for the cosine value. The integral of cosine is sine, and we can evaluate it at pi over 6 here. And the sine of 0 will just be 0, so we get that subtraction here. And we can move our terms around here, so we have vi in the front. Evaluate this. We know that sine of pi over 6 is just going to be 1/2. So we can put that in here. We can cancel out the 6 and the 2, and we'll end up with this equation. The average voltage for the output of a three-phase full-wave rectifier is Vi, and this Vi is the RMS value of the neutral to line voltage times 3 times the square root of 6 divided by pi. An alternative way of calculating it is to think about the original waveform that we used to calculate this difference. If you think about it, that actually it's two half-wave rectifiers, one in the positive direction and one in the negative direction. So the positive one is shown with the black line on the top, and then the negative one is shown down here. So the average of these two is actually just going to subtract from each other. So the average of the top one is this equation that we derived before, and then we're going to have that same equation in the negative direction. And for full wave rectification, you can think about it as the positive voltage, the average, minus the negative average. So this equation shown here. You just plug in these values, put them together, the negatives will end up being a positive, and you just add them together, and you'll end up with the same exact equations. In summary, the three-phase full-wave rectifier has six diodes, this circuit down here, and its voltage is going to be up here, has six different bumps on it, and we can do two different ways to derive the same exact equation. What we'll end up with is the voltage is equal to Vi 3 root 6 divided by pi, and this Vi is the neutral to line RMS voltage of the input.